Well, have you found the cause of this aura? This shroud?
She slinks forward until her face is mere inches from your own.
I owe you a debt. But I already know what you desire. And I intend to pay in full. Right now. Tell me, do you know exactly what I am? In a manner of speaking, my dear. But I am so much more. I am a succubus. Love is my power. It enthralls those who I seduce and feeds me yet more power. It is through this aspect of myself that I must reward you.
You realize that her hand is caressing your arm. She gazes at you intently. Her eyes are oceans of violet. You could drown in them.
You have my word, though. I will not use my powers to make you my thrall. Just as I hope you won't use what I show you to become some sort of tyrant. Mahali understands who I am. That's why we're meant to be together.
She grins devilishly and pulls you close.
Let's see what you're made of.
She kisses you. She devours. Suddenly she's all blinding light and come hither heat. You enter her heat, thrust upon thrust, until she scalds and with a scream, her nails digging for blood, all becomes an echo of the primal soul, a burst of overwhelming white. Slowly the heat abates as she releases you with a kiss. Your vision swims back into view, Almira observing you with a knowing smile.
A lesson worth learning, was it not? Once you've caught your breath, I actually have another little request for you.
You have helped me to escape immediate danger, but I remain a fugitive from my old life and the promises I made to it. The Black Ring swear allegiance to a powerful being, the God King. This is not a mere oath of duty, this is the covenant. And those who accept it are bound to the God King. They are sworn. I am sworn. You have to understand, Lucien's death fog broke us. We were left defeated, leaderless. And then the God King started to speak to us. He offered victory, immortality, anything we desired in exchange for loyalty. How could we refuse? Once you are sworn, there is no escape. Your life is the God King's. Fail or betray him, and you are doomed. Unless you find a way to break the covenant. That is where you come in, my dear. I discovered the existence of ancient implements called Sworn Breakers. They are rumored to be able to break any magical pact, including the covenant. And while enslaved by the Magisters, I noticed a tablet in their excavation site in the Black Pits. It bore markings that looked very similar to how these Sworn Breakers were described to me.
She smiles, fixing those violet eyes upon you once again.
Will you retrieve it for me?
He is a god for the godless. A beacon for those who have no place in this world. He seeks to cast down the world of the Seven and build a new world with the Sworn at his side. The Black Ring flock to him after Lucien unleashed his death fog. The undead stand by him because he offers them a return to life. I don't know why the Voidwoken flock to him, but I want to be with Mahali. That is why the God King and I must part ways. That is why I need a Sworn Breaker. It is a promise that you cannot break, unless you want to end up broken yourself. Those who are sworn to it are bound to the God King, come victory or defeat. If you try to break the covenant unprepared, then you are sealing your own fate.
Who needs thralls, when I have selfless acquaintances such as yourself? By the by, a black little birdie told me you've a ship along the shore. That is where we'll go. Enjoy a bit of sun while we wait.
It's like there's fire in my blood. I never imagined such power.
Once more, you feel your soul expand with raw source. Deep inside, your God calls for you again. You should perform the Meister's ritual one last time, here or in Siva's vault.
How fares the hunt, my friend? May you wander.
What is that thing?
Please, Lord, spare me. Spare me. It is too much. My heart, too much. You cannot come here. I'm not done.
The creature suddenly holds itself around the ears, as though seized by a great pain. Several flapping jaws open and close over a single many-fanged maw, like a taxidermist's experiment. Before you lies a primitive altar to the Seven, apparently constructed during a bygone era. Something about it appeals to you. A faint heat emanating from the stones, perhaps. The altar waits for someone.
Go!
His frantic gaze passes from the blood-stained altar to you. Comprehension suddenly clears the agony from his face.
He wants blood. He wants blood. My lord, I'll give you blood. I'll give it all. I beg you, my lord. Accept.
your maker.
Thank you.
Before you lies a primitive altar. The altar waits for... An ancient altar to the Seven stands alone before you. Faint, comforting heat emanating from the stones themselves calls you forward. The stones appear to be just that. Apart from a few faded red stains across the topmost slab, nothing unusual betrays itself. Gentle heat warms your hand. The air stirs, as though someone had appeared and taken a seat upon the altar. A voice rises around you, its source unclear. Fractured whispers surround you. Hurry.
Someone's already plucked this one. There's a boat at the dock. Perhaps it may take us to the island.
These people were slain by blades, not Voidwoken.
I'll give you fair warning, stranger. Turn around and get out of here unless you want to end up like this treacherous filth.
Thank you.
He throws a kick into the ribs of a nearby corpse.
What they did deserved a lot worse than what they got. This lot were sorcerer sympathizers. Good magisters died thanks to the one they were hiding.
He gestures around at the Voidwoken wrought destruction in the area.
They forced our hand. We've got to do whatever's necessary to hold the rot at bay. Fool, you could have just walked away.
Please, I beg you. I beg you.
Killed by Voidwoken, who were in turn killed themselves.
Are you proud? Proud to stand in the way of justice. Proud that you'd allow Voidwoken to raise the land. Proud of your wrongs.
A crooked sneer surfaces from the spirit's deep pit of contempt.
The Order has something you could never understand. A code.
His sneer widens.
Traitors like you. You have no code. You blindly ricochet from one conflict to the next, stirring the pot while scolding the virtuous. You pretend to have honor. But you're a fraud.
Someone will come, I know it. Someone, please release me!
Dear Ralik, dear Lucian, save us from this hell!
Untie me. Please. Thank you.
Her tear-stained cheeks quiver as she surveys the blood-spattered floorboards.
It's like a bad nightmare. Except, please, you never wake up.
The young man grunts as he fruitlessly tries to free his hands from the heavy knotted rope.
Thanks.
He looks to his slain brother's body, please, his eyes well with tears, though none break free.
We didn't deserve this. We didn't deserve any of this.
The spirit of a dwarf woman stares despondently at her
A word of the wise, friend. Never help a sorcerer. They'll only bring death in their wake. You're the same as the one who did this. Dragging monsters into our homes and taking none of the responsibility. Get away from me.
A snarl of vines snakes upward from the corpse. After a moment, you realize the gruesome truth. They're not entangling the corpse, but bursting from it. The vines have split the corpse's chest with incredible force. Thin roots wriggle from limbs and nail beds, anchoring it to the ground. The vines encircle a rough depression, as if something held there was violently torn free. Before you even registered the cool flesh, the vines lash around your wrist and drag you close. They pulse, tightening mercilessly, and release you, withdrawing sluggishly, as if sated, for now.
Who are you?
Mm-hmm.
yield to none.
Thank you.
Don't hurt me! Like I told them magisters, you can search the house all you want. The sorcerer ain't here, the door's locked, and the house ain't even mine. Magisters told me to stand out front till they caught the sorcerer, and I don't want to upset them when they're on the warpath.
She closes her eyes and begins to whisper.
Everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be all right.
It's always the same tale. You're boring me.
I've said all I know. Please.
Ho hum. I've heard all this before. You really need to work on your storytelling skills. Maybe if I make this simple. You tell me where it's always the same tale. You're boring me.
I've said all I know. Please.
Ho hum. Don't toy with me, sorcerer. You know where she is, and I know you know it, so talk.
I don't know where Hanag's gone. I tell you if I did. I swear on my father's grave.
Oh, he swears. Did you hear that, everyone? He swears. Why, that's almost as good as a pinky promise.
The White Magister swiftly pivots towards you and draws her blade.
Did you come for the show, then? Good timing. The interrogation scene is over, so we're almost at the climax.
She chuckles and pokes the inside of her cheek with her tongue.
Oh, I just love when random adventurers come to play hero. It's almost like they think fairy tales are real. Now drop the strongman axe, sit yourself down and make yourself comfortable. First-rate entertainment, this is.
The sorcerer fidgets, and you notice a thin dagger resting in his palm. He slices away a bit of rope, then looks at you, eyebrows raised.
Godwalken.
A shocked awareness spreads across her face, and she lunges towards you, just as the hanging sorcerer breaks free of his bond.
Damn you. Damn all of you. Thank you.
Godwoken, the void seeks you.
yourself. Hurts, doesn't it? need your men.
Thank you.
Prepare yourself.
Thank you. Just when I think this land holds no more...
Still, at least this is an intri...
Spotted something.
Look out.
To watch my
I see a trap nearby. Look out! I see a trap nearby.
This corpse is wearing black ring garb. How strange. Careful! I've spotted a trap. Careful! I've spotted a trap. Careful! I've spotted a trap.
Ouch! Looks like we're ripped.
Look out! I see a trap nearby.
see a trap nearby. Careful, I've spotted a trap. Look out! I see a trap nearby.